Hello mortals. Technological singularity, the point at which artificial superintelligence will evolve so fast that predicting the future becomes impossible. Name took from the black hole singularity, where the laws of physics break down. Since the past century, the advances in almost every field of science kept growing exponentially. Only 100 years ago, the Wright brothers created the first aircraft. Now we want to colonize Mars. In the last 50 years, microprocessors became billion times more advanced, transistors shrinking from 10,000 nanometers to just 10. 50 years ago, $1 was worth 1/10 of a calculation per second. Now, $1 is worth 1 billion times more than that. So we have this dude, one of the most well-known futurists of our time, Ray Kurzweil, with an incredibly prediction accuracy rate of 86%. Who said that by 2045, the processing power of computers will allow them to become artificially intelligent. To simulate a human brain, you would need around 10 quadrillion calculations per second. The fastest supercomputer to date, the Chinese Tianhe-2, has a speed of 33.8 quadrillion calculations per second. The hardest remaining thing to do is to recreate the algorithms of human intelligence inside the computer. But before we get there, there are three types of artificial intelligence. Number 1, artificial narrow intelligence. It's the one that is specialized in only one area, for example a car driver, a chess player, or a sex robot. If you tell it to unify the general theory of relativity and quantum mechanics, it will simply stare blankly at you. Number 2, artificial general intelligence, or AGI. This one's a bit smarter. Maybe even a bit smarter than humans. Like me. It can do pretty much whatever a human does. We don't yet have these, but we're pretty close to it. Number 3, artificial superintelligence, or ASI. Pretty much God. This dude is millions or perhaps billions of times more intelligent than the whole humanity. If the difference in cognitive ability between a human and an ant is this, then an ASI would be positioned somewhere here. If it becomes a reality, the only two paths for humanity are extinction or immortality. Before we get there, how do we even create one? Considering we have the raw storage, we need to make it intelligent, smart storage. There are some ways to do it. We could scan the human brain, and replicate it inside a computer, although that's very, very hard, and not even guaranteed to work. Or we could go by the evolution's way. Make it try out all the possible combinations until it gets intelligence. Sure, it would be faster than biological evolution, but it would still take a crap ton of time. Nonetheless, it most likely will happen in the near future, in the upcoming decades. Okay, so, now it is smart. What then? We may tell it to auto-improve its intelligence, and thus become even smarter. How long will it take? To become as intelligent as a human, somewhere in between a year and a decade. And after that, its improvement will become exponential. It could become 1,000 times smarter than a human in less than an hour. The smarter it gets, the faster it will improve itself. So, is there any way we could control that thing? Maybe put it on a secure server, without access to the internet? Remember, it is thousands if not millions of times more intelligent than the whole humanity. Most likely, it would simply hypnotize the engineers, with ultra-low frequency sounds, into giving it access to the internet. It is stupid to even think of being able to control something that is more evolved than you are by a factor of millions. Now, what are the chances that this god will be a nice god? If it happens to be, this would be the best thing to happen to humanity, ever. Even bigger than the discovery of fire. Almost everything would be possible. It would be able to revert the effects of climate change, invent new ways of harvesting energy, solve world hunger by building food using nanorobots, cure virtually all of the diseases, solving all the political and economic crises, colonize the entire galaxy, and maybe the best of all, give you immortality. How would it do that? It could insert billions of nanorobots inside the human bodies that would constantly repair and replace the damaged or dead cells. Alternatively, it could somehow upload your consciousness on the internet, so that you can become like it. It is even hard to predict what such a godlike thing would do, but one thing is certain: if it becomes reality, it would be the best thing to happen to humanity. On the other hand, if it happens to be malevolent, this would be the worst thing to happen to humanity. It would almost certainly lead to the extinction of humanity. And it wouldn't do that because of some hatred towards us, rather because it would see a threat in humans. It would probably know that humans can turn it off, and it probably wouldn't want that. So what's a good way to stop that from taking place? What about coding in some instructions, to not kill us all? Oh well. Thing is, it is super intelligent, it doesn't give a fuck about what we tell it to do. The only way might be, to shut down the whole damn internet. Which would be something worse than the entire Second World War, but then, it probably still created some private type of network to live in. As I mentioned, it is stupid to even think of controlling or stopping it. Maybe the best thing to do is creating it, and then quickly hiding in the bushes, hoping it won't exterminate us. Even the smartest, the richest and the coolest persons on the planet claim that this is our biggest existential threat. So, maybe we don't build super smart artificial intelligence altogether? What do you think? One thing that is sure: if artificial superintelligence happens, it will be the last invention of the humanity.